this at earlier stage, we will not have the company of Dr. S.C. Sri Kumar. But now we have his company, and so many software update we could not have done if it has been done earlier. But we could do all these things by now. And regarding this digital library, I would like to say a few things about the development of the digital library, why it is important in the context of the developing countries like Nepal. In the developing country, so there are so many infrastructures are not available, just like telecommunication infrastructures, the electricity infrastructures, all these are needed for telecommunication systems. But in spite of these things, so whenever these things are not available, in the developing countries, some of the things develops quickly as compared to the developed country, which is called the leapfrog. And similarly, the digital library also has developed in developing countries rapidly as compared to the developed country. There are so many reasons for the development of digital library in developing countries. First of all is the access to the information. Earlier, if we see a particular medical library in a developed country, usually the trend is around 2,000 to 3,000 medical journals is available in physical format in the developed countries. But the same type of medical library, if we see in the developing countries, we hardly see 10 medical journals. So you see the differences between. But with the development of the digital library, the cost of access to the medical journals is marginally zero. So with the development of the digital library, the same number of journals could be accessed from the digital, from the developing countries, like in developed countries. So this is the one of the development which we have seen these days. In case of Nepal, the WHO through the Inari projects provides access to 4,000 medical journals. Similarly, in disaster relief, quickly some informations are needed for management. So this could also be provided in consolidated form. Yes, culture. There are indigenous culture available in developing countries. But these things could not be recorded because in the developing countries, the persons are not so in the context of Nepal. Most of the cultural indigenous cultures has been written in English language. So most of the Nepalese point of the digital library, there is no need to write in systematic manner. A reference says these things can be collected and put in the digital form. And we could publish this and make the interface in our national language. So to reduce, it has helped to reduce the barriers of the barriers and with regard to the developments are published in a very few copies, and these things are never published in a commercial book form. And after some time, these things are lost. But these are the informations which actually charts the development of a country. And these are the informations which is needed for planning purposes. But with the development of the digital library, these things can be preserved for a long time. And therefore, instead of regenerating these information, this can be captured easily from any part of the country or from any part of the world. And the other thing is that information sharing, with development of the digital library and with the development of the internet, information can easily be shared, and there is no need to duplicate. duplicate the information. This, so the digital library has also helped to achieve these objectives. So by these things, I'll stop at here.